Hello everyone, welcome to Pharmacy Lectures. Today we are going to discuss Sikimate pathway and how various aromatic amino acids are produced from this pathway. The Sikimate pathway related to aromatic amino acids and phenylpropanoids. The Sikimate pathway provides an alternative route to aromatic compounds. These aromatic amino acids are L-phenylalanine, L-tyrosine and L-tryptophan. These three aromatic amino acids are produced by Sikimate pathway. And this pathway is particularly employed by microorganisms and plants only. And animals cannot utilize this pathway, so animals have to obtain from the diet these aromatic amino acids. And these phenylalanine and tyrosine, of the three aromatic amino acids, these two, phenylalanine and tyrosine, they form the basis of C6C3 phenylpropane units. C6, it stands for phenyl, and C3 it stands for propane. And this C6C3 phenylpropane unit is majorly found in these structures, in cinnamic acids, in coumarins, in lignans, in flavonoids. You can see there is presence of C6C3 phenylpropane units. Along with tryptophan, this tryptophan is particularly and especially found in alkaloid structures and other various structures also. And one more significance of this pathway, Sikimic acid pathway, is that currently the raw material for synthesis of antiviral drug oseltamivir, which is very demand against the bird flu. From this Sikimic acid, this antiviral drug oseltamivir is produced. Let's see here. The three aromatic amino acids produced by Sikimate pathway are L-phenylalanine, L-tyrosine, and L-tryptophan. If you see the name of this structure, you see here phenyl and alanine. Okay, this is the phenyl, and this portion, this rest of the portion is alanine. And if you see the structure of L-tyrosine, there is only one difference between L-phenylalanine and L-tyrosine, a single difference. I think you have figured out. The difference is, if we replace the fourth position hydrogen of phenylalanine by hydroxy, then the new structure is L-tyrosine. So this is the very simple difference. And if we talk about the structure of L-tryptophan, here are two aromatic rings. One aromatic ring is phenyl, okay, this aromatic ring, and this aromatic ring is pyrrole. The phenyl and pyrrole are fused to each other. Okay, and of this pyrrole, if we talk about its numbering starts from here, NH, it is positioned number 1, it is positioned number 2, and this is number 3. And at this position number 3, the substituent which is here, the name of the substituent is alanine. Okay, in all these structures, look at here, in phenylalanine there is alanine, in L-tyrosine there is alanine, and in L-tryptophan also there is alanine. So it is very simple structure, no need to worry about it. Now let's see how these aromatic amino acids are produced by plant and microorganism, by what processes plant produces it. The basic material required for a Sikimate pathway is phosphoenol pyruvate. This is a derivative, you can call it a derivative of pyruvic acid. And another material required is D-erythrose 4-phosphate. These both can be obtained from glycolysis. And if you talk about the structure of this phosphoenol pyruvate, first let me draw the structure of pyruvic acid. Okay, C double bond O, and here also I have to draw like this, C double bond O and OH. It contains three carbon unit. Okay, this is carbon number 1, this is carbon number 2, and this is carbon number 3. This is the structure of pyruvic acid. Here are three carbons, 1 carbon, 2 carbon, 3 carbon, and here also it contains 3 carbon. Carbon number 1, carbon number 2, and carbon number 3. The difference is between these two structures is, this is pyruvic acid and this is phosphoenol pyruvate. Let me draw, this is a keto form of pyruvic acid, okay? You can see here, this is a keto form of pyruvic acid. Now let me draw the enol form of pyruvic acid. Now, the structure I am going to draw is the enol form of pyruvic acid. The hydrogen from here gets attached to here, and the enol form of pyruvic acid gets formed. This is keto, C double bond OH. And this is the enol form of pyruvic acid. And of this enol, this hydrogen, okay, this hydrogen is replaced by phosphate. If this hydrogen is replaced by phosphate, then our structure is phosphoenol pyruvate. Phospho means for phosphate, enol means enol form of pyruvate. And this phosphoenol pyruvate and this dithiophosphate, they undergo reaction. The reaction is aldol type reaction, and the reaction is carried out by the enzyme called DAHP synthase. This enzyme will carry out the aldol type reaction. And I think all of you have know the aldol type reaction. In generally, aldol reaction occurs between aldehyde and ketone, which are having alpha hydrogen, and there is an intermediate product in aldol reaction and there is a final product. The intermediate product in aldol reaction is beta hydroxy aldehyde ketone, and the final product in aldol reaction is alpha beta unsaturated aldehyde ketone. The product why this name is given aldol type reaction here is because the product formed here is beta hydroxy ketone, you can call it. It is a beta hydroxy aldehyde ketone, you can call it anything. It is a beta hydroxy compound. If you look at the numbering, this keto, beta hydroxy aldehyde ketone, okay. So keto must be numbered 1, this is number 2, this is number 3. This is alpha carbon, this is carbon alpha, and this is carbon beta. At this beta carbon, there is a hydroxy group, okay. The intermediate product in aldol type reaction is beta hydroxy aldehyde ketone, and you can see this is a beta hydroxy ketone. So this can be called as a aldol type reaction because the intermediate is beta hydroxy ketone. Now let's see the mechanism here. The phosphate of this phosphoenol pyruvate, the phosphate groups gets removed from here, and this alkene, okay, this alkene attacks on this carbon, and this acts as a carbocation after gaining this proton here, okay. And this electron rich nucleophile type molecule will attack here, and here this carbon will form bond, and here of this aldehyde hydroxy will form. You can see here this is aldehyde and here it is hydroxy, and our compound gets formed. The name of the compound is DAHP. Now if we clearly look at the name of the structure in here, it is called 3-deoxy, okay. At position number 3, if we have to count from number 1 here, this is position number 1, this is position number 2, and this is position number 3. It is 3-deoxy, means there is not oxygen containing functional group, okay. There is not hydroxy group. And D-arabino, and all of you know that in arabinose sugar, okay, in sugar moieties, all of you know that sugar moieties are aldehyde ketone moieties, and except the carbon containing aldehyde ketone, all the carbons contain hydroxy group. But here one of the carbon do not contain hydroxy, so that's why it is called 3-deoxy. At 3 position there is not hydroxy, that's why it is called 3-deoxy. D-arabino means sugar type molecule. Heptilosonic acid means 7 carbon containing molecule having acid functional group. And at position number 7, this is position number 3, this is position number 4, this is 5, this is 6, and this is 7. At position number 7, there is a phosphate group. That's why it is called 3-deoxy, D-arabino, heptilosonic acid, 7-phosphate. Okay, let me repeat this once again. Phosphoenol pyruvate, it is a derivative of like pyruvic acid. Here phosphate group get removed from here, and this alkene will attack on this carbon, this oxygen will gain hydrogen, and it will form a hydroxy in here, and here a beta hydroxy compound is formed, okay. This is carbon 0, this is carbon alpha, this is carbon beta. That's why it is called aldol type reaction. Now let's see the next reaction. The next reaction here is 3-dehydroquinate synthase, okay. This enzyme will carry out the reaction in presence of nicotinamide adenine dinucleotide, in presence of this, and first intermediate forms here, and after the formation of intermediate, the product gets formed here. Now let's see the intermediate, but before looking at intermediate, we must see what it is trying to show in here. It is trying to show in here that here this phosphate gets removed from here, okay. this phosphate. P means phosphate, and it will take hydrogen also from here. It will take hydrogen from here and gets phosphate group gets removed from here. So here a double bond will be formed. Now let's see at the structure. Here is a double bond, okay, and here is a hydroxy as it is. Look at this hydroxy. This hydroxy is this hydroxy, and double bond gets formed here. Phosphate group is removed, and now again this alkene will attack on this carbon, and this oxygen will gain a hydrogen similar to this reaction. Here also this alkene has attacked on this carbon, and this oxygen has gained hydrogen, just like this reaction. This also aldol type reaction. Here also a beta hydroxy compound is formed. Look at here, this is a ketone. Okay, of this ketone, this is carbon alpha and this is carbon beta. At this beta carbon there is a hydroxy, so that's why this is also called aldol type reaction, because here also beta hydroxy ketone is formed. And the name of this structure is 3-dehydroquinic acid. It is named, its name is based on quinic acid. If you look at the structure of quinic acid, it will be like this. Okay, OH here COOH, and at position number 1, 2, 3, this is not aromatic. Okay, don't assume it as aromatic. I mistakenly drawn it as aromatic. Here is a hydroxy. Okay, here is a OH, and here is also OH. If the structure is like this, it is not aromatic in here, then it is a quinic acid. And if in that quinic acid the hydrogen is removed, the hydrogens are removed, then it is called 3-dehydroquinic acid. And the next enzyme which comes in action is 3-dehydroquinase. 3-dehydroquinase comes in action, and this 3-dehydroquinase will remove hydroxy from here and hydrogen from here. Hydroxy and hydrogen gets here eliminated, and here a double bond is formed here. Like you can see here a double bond is formed, and this structure after the action of enzyme 3-dehydroquinase, its name is 3-dehydrosicamic acid. And this 3-dehydrosicamic acid, it can undergo various transformation also. The plant or microorganism can utilize it by oxidizing and enolization. Plants can form gallic acid. You can see here gallic acid can be formed, or the plant can use the enzyme 3-dehydrosicamate dehydratase and form protocatechic acid. But our motto here is to understand how L-phenylalanine, L-tyrosine and L-tryptophan are formed from succinic acid. Our motto is here, so let's discuss here. Now 3-dehydrosicamic acid in presence of enzyme succinate dehydrogenase and the cofactor NADPH, here this keto group, okay, this keto group gets reduced to hydroxy, to secondary alcohol. Whenever a ketone group gets reduced, it always forms secondary alcohol. Here also succinate dehydrogenase reduces the keto and forms secondary alcohol, and now this structure is called succinic acid. Now again, this is the simple pathway. I want to draw a structure here. All the names are written as it is without a drawing structure. So let us repeat once again. Phosphoenyl pyruvate and D-erythrose 4-phosphate, both are the product of glycolysis. This is a 3-carbon unit, and this is a 4-carbon unit. And the DASP which forms here, it is a 7-carbon unit. It forms in presence of enzyme DASP synthase, and the reaction which occurs here is aldol type reaction, because here a beta hydroxy compound is formed. Beta hydroxy or dihydroketone is formed. This full form of DASP is 3-deoxy-D-arabinoheptylosonic acid 7-phosphate, and again this enzyme comes in action, 3-dehydroquinate synthase, and the product formed is 3-dehydroquinic acid. And again 3-dehydroquinase comes in action, and it removes a water molecule from the structure, and the new structure formed is 3-dehydrosicamic acid. And from this succinic acid, plant can either form gallic acid, plant can also form protocatechic acid, and If this enzyme comes in action, sickimate dehydrogenase, and if it gets cofactor NADPH, the product formed is sickimic acid. And now let's see what happens from sickimic acid. From sickimic acid, in presence of energy unit ATP and sickimate kinase, whenever you see the enzyme kinase, you have to automatically understand that some phosphate group is going to add in the molecule. This enzyme is going to add phosphate group in the structure. Here also phosphate group gets added. It gets added to position number 3 hydroxy group. This is position number 3. At this position number 3 hydroxy, this hydrogen gets removed and phosphate group gets attached here. And this structure's name is sickimic acid 3-phosphate. Sickimic acid as it is, at position number 3, 1, 2, 3, there is a phosphate. So that's why sickimic acid 3-phosphate. And now again, one more phosphoenol pyruvate molecule comes in contact here, because we have to extend this, extend here, two carbons, we have to add more carbons, because for phenylalanine, it is a phenylpropane unit, okay? Phenylalanine is a phenylpropane unit. It is a phenyl and propane. This is methyl, this is ethyl, and this is propane. So COH, it do not satisfy that. We have to add more carbons, and the more carbon comes from phosphoenol pyruvate. And here also same thing happens. This lone pair of oxygen will attack on this carbon. Okay, it acts as a nucleophile. It attacks on this carbon, and now this acts as a nucleophile and attacks on this hydrogen. And here is a CS2, and it will gain a hydrogen, this H, and it will form CS3. After gaining this hydrogen, it will be CS3. And here this oxygen, okay, this oxygen will form bond with this carbon, and in presence of enzyme EPSP synthase, this reaction occurs. The product forms is EPSP, and there is an intermediate also. Like I said earlier, here CS3 is formed, okay, and here oxygen and carbon are bonded. This carbon and oxygen are bonded. Like I said here, this carbon and this oxygen gets bonded, and here is CS2 and one hydrogen. This hydrogen gets added here, and CS3 is formed. Phosphate is as it is, and this carboxylate is as it is. Look at here, this phosphate is as it is and carboxylate is as it is. Now what happens here is, there is 1-2 elimination of phosphoric acid. Phosphoric acid gets eliminated. This is the phosphoric acid, simpler. Here OP for this group, and H for this. It has said like that. And here what happens, hydrogen gets removed from here. This is position number 1, this is position number 2. There is 1-2 elimination. From one carbon, phosphate group gets removed, and another carbon, hydrogen gets removed. So overall, phosphoric acid gets removed. And this is intermediate, and the compound formed is EPSP, 5-enol pyruvyl sickimic acid. You can look clearly here, it is written enol pyruvyl. So this structure, it is an enol form of pyruvic acid. Okay, this structure is what? It is an enol form of pyruvic acid. If you draw the structure of pyruvic acid once again, I would like to draw here C-1O, OH. This is pyruvic acid, and this is the enol form of pyruvic acid. Double bond is here, and here is a double bond, C-1O, OH. Double bond is here, okay, this is not double bond. And here is, this is the enol form of pyruvic acid. You can see here this hydrogen gets removed, and from this oxygen there is a bonding. Between this oxygen and carbon. And this is the enol pyruvyl group. This group is enol pyruvyl group, and the rest of the molecule is sickimic acid 3-phosphate. That's why its name is 5-enol pyruvyl sickimic acid 3-phosphate. And next, this enzyme comes in action, corismate synthase, and it will help in the synthesis of corismic acid. And there is also elimination of phosphoric acid, and the elimination is 1-4 elimination. This is carbon 1 for this elimination, this is 2, this is 3, and this is 4. One hydrogen gets removed from here at this position, and phosphate groups gets removed from here. That's why it is called one for elimination, and this double bond gets transferred over here and a new double bond is created in here. And let's see the structure. This is the structure of racemic acid. Here is a double bond and one more double bond is created in here. Okay, phosphate group is eliminated, one for elimination phosphoric acid, and racemic acid is formed. And from this racemic acid, in presence of another enzyme racemate mutase, this racemate mutase will form mutation type reaction here. This enol pyruvyl group, which you can see here, this enol pyruvyl group gets transferred to this position. Okay, gets transferred to this position. You can clearly see here, this is enol pyruvyl group previously, but now it is keto pyruvyl. Okay, previously it was enol pyruvyl, here was a double bond CH2, now it is here it is hydroxy, now it is keto pyruvyl, and here is hydroxy as it is, and the double bond gets also transferred over here, this double bond gets transferred over here, and hydroxy is as it is. And the name of this new product is perfenic acid. And here also a decarboxylation occurs. Okay, in this structure, perfenic acid structure, further in presence of perfenate dehydratase, decarboxylation occurs, and this CO2 gets eliminated, and aromatization occurs. There one more double bond is created in here, it stands for here's aromatization occurs here, and loss of leaving group, and this hydroxy also gets removed from here, and the compound, new compound formed is phenyl pyruvic acid. Like I said earlier, the structure of pyruvic acid, I think you already all know, this is the structure of pyruvic acid, and this is phenyl. Phenyl is attached to pyruvic acid, so its name is phenyl pyruvic acid. And now we are just one step apart from formation of L-phenylalanine. Now pyruvic acid, in presence of this cofactor pyridoxal phosphate, this pyridoxal phosphate will provide NH2 group, and the enzyme phenyl pyruvate aminotransferase, it will transfer amino group, it will not provide amino group, it will provide the keto group, it will help in the transfer, it will take amino group. Okay, I think I am doing mistake again. Okay, it will give amino group. Yes, so this pyridoxal phosphate will provide amino group. This will provide NH2 group, and this keto oxygen will get removed, and NH2 group will be added here. As you can see here, NH2 group is added here. So this pyridoxal phosphate will provide NH2 group. The enzyme which utilizes in here is phenyl pyruvate aminotransferase. This is a phenyl pyruvate structure. And to this phenyl pyruvate structure, amine group is transferred in here. That's why it is called, this enzyme is called phenyl pyruvate aminotransferase, and our L-phenylalanine is formed. Okay, let's revise this once again, the formation of L-phenylalanine up to this. These two our substrates, phosphoenol pyruvate and D-erythrose-4-phosphate, undergo aldol type reaction in presence of enzyme DASP synthase, and there is a removal of phosphate group also, and this aldehyde group gets converted into hydroxy group. Okay, that's why it is called aldol type reaction, because there is a beta hydroxy ketone, this is carbon zero, this is carbon alpha, this is carbon beta, that's why this is called aldol type reaction, and the compound gets formed is DASP 3-deoxy D-arabino heptylosonic acid 7-phosphate. It's a 7 carbon containing sugar type molecule, and the enzyme next which comes in action is 3D hydroquinate synthase, and the product formed is 3D hydroquinic acid. Here you can see this product is 3D hydroquinic acid. This is also aldol type reaction. Here also this is carbon zero, this is carbon alpha, this is carbon beta. Here also beta hydroxy ketone is formed, that's why it is also given name aldol type reaction. Here also this alkene will attack on this carbon, and this oxygen will gain H plus and gets converted to hydroxy. And next 3D hydroquinase comes in action, and it will remove water molecule, this hydroxy and one hydrogen from here gets removed, and a double bond is created in here, and the product formed is 3D hydroxychemic acid. And next from this 3-dehydroxycimic acid, the enzyme which comes in action is next cycimate dehydrogenase. This cycimate dehydrogenase will reduce in presence of NADPH. To whom it will reduce? It will reduce the keto group. This cycimate dehydrogenase will reduce this keto to hydroxy, and the compound's name is cycimic acid. This is a key intermediate in the formation of aromatic amino acids. That's why it is the given name. The pathway's name is given cycimate pathway. And this 3-dehydroxycimic acid can also form gallic acid and protocatechic acid in presence of various enzymes. And let's see further. We have all discussed here these all points. Cycimic acid in presence of cycimate kinase and energy unit ATP, it will form cycimic acid 3-phosphate. Okay, at position number 3, it's position number 1, position number 2, position number 3, there is a phosphate group. That's why it is called cycimic acid 3-phosphate. And one more phosphonyl pyruvate comes here to get attached in here. And because number of carbon atoms are not satisfied till now, we need two more carbons. And so the reaction occurs like this position number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Position number 5's hydroxy group, this lone pair of oxygen will attack in here as a nucleophile, and this alkene will attack on hydrogen as a nucleophile. And the bond is created between this oxygen and this carbon, and here a CH3 is formed. Okay, let's see here. This is an intermediate before the formation of EPSP. Here the phosphate group is here, a CH3 group is here. And when hydrogen gets removed from here and phosphate gets removed from here, a double bond is created. See here, double bond. And the name of this compound EPSP, its name is like 5-enol pyruvyl cycimic acid 3-phosphate. This is position number 1, this is 2, this is 3, this is 4, and this is 5. At position number 5, the group attached is enol pyruvyl group. Okay, pyruvic acids enol form. That's why it is called enol pyruvyl. And here also, 1,4 elimination of phosphoric acid gets done here. Phosphate group gets attached from here. This is position number 1 for this elimination. 1, 2, 3, 4. Now at position number 4, when hydrogen gets removed. So that's why it is called 1,4 elimination of phosphoric acid. And the enzyme which makes this reaction possible, it is coricimate synthase, and the cofactor required is FMNH2. Okay, after the elimination of 1,4 phosphoric acid from here and here, the coricimic acid gets formed, and coricimic acid in presence of enzyme coricimate mutase will turn into perphenic acid. Here this 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, this fifth positions enol pyruvyl will be transferred to position number 1, and it will not be transferred as enol pyruvyl, it will be transferred as keto pyruvyl. It will transferred as pyruvyl, you can simply call it pyruvyl. And in this perphenic acid there are three reactions going on. Okay, one reaction is decarboxylation. This CO2 group gets removed. Okay, it gets decarboxylated. Another reaction is aromatization. One more double bond is created in here. Okay, and leaving group, loss of leaving group, this hydroxygate gets removed from here, and our phenyl pyruvic acid is formed. And in this phenyl pyruvic acid, pyridoxal phosphate and phenyl pyruvate aminotransferase, they will remove this keto, and they will transfer amino group, and our L-phenylalanine is formed. This is one of our major product in the cycimate pathway. And let's see the synthesis of tyrosine and L-tryptophan. And one more important thing, the L-phenylalanine, if the E2 elimination, this bimolecular elimination ammonia occurs in this, if ammonia NH2 gets removed from here and a hydrogen gets removed, then a double bond is created. Okay, you can see here. Then this cinnamic acid is produced like this. Let's see the synthesis of tyrosine. Perphenic acid in presence of PLP, pyridoxal phosphate, and perphenate aminotransferase. This will transfer amino group to whom? To the keto position it will transfer. Okay. It will transfer amino group in here. Alright. This perphenate aminotransferase will transfer amino group in place of this keto. And this structure's name is L-arogenic acid. And here aerogenate dehydrogenase. This enzyme will facilitate the decarboxylation in here, and after it's a decarboxylation, our L tyrosine is formed. This is also clear. Now next, last portion is synthesis of L-tryptophan, and this synthesis of L-tryptophan, it occurs from coricic acid. Okay, look at here, coricic acid in presence of 2-amino-2-deoxy isocoricimate synthase, it forms 2-amino-2-deoxy isocoricimic acid. Here during the formation, at position number 1, 2, okay, this is position 2, at position number 2, what happens, amino group is attached here. You can see in coricic acid there is no amino group, and in 2-amino-2-deoxy isocoricimic acid there is an amino group. Okay, amino group gets attached in here, and it is called a 2-amino-2-deoxy isocoricimic acid because in isocoricimic acid there is a hydroxy group also in here. Now there is no hydroxy group, there is amino group, that's why it is called 2-amino-2-deoxy isocoricimic acid, because previously in isocoricimic acid there was hydroxy and now there is no hydroxy, so that's why it is called like this. And now next, in the presence of this enzyme 2-amino-2-deoxy isocoricimate lyase, elimination of pyruvic acid occurs. This pyruvic acid gets eliminated in presence of this enzyme lyase, 2-amino-2-deoxy isocoricimate lyase. And after the elimination of this pyruvic acid, the compound's name will be, and your hydroxy group also gets removed. Okay, the name of this compound is anthranilic acid, and here are also four more enzymes will act upon this compound, and they will form L-tryptophan. This will be a very long tedious process, so that's why I haven't shown you these reactions. You can go through the book if you want more. And another important thing, the significance of this pathway is para-aminobenzoic acid, plants and microorganisms can form. It is easily found from coricic acid. Coricic acid in presence of enzyme 4-amino-4-deoxy isocoricimate synthase, it will form 4-amino-4-deoxy isocoricimic acid. And further, in the presence of enzyme lyase, you have seen previous the action of this enzyme lyase. Wherever lyase occurs, it will break down some part of the molecule. Here this lyase will remove or cut off this pyruvic acid, and after this cut off, the para-aminobenzoic acid is formed. You can pause the video and watch this video more clearly if you want. Okay, if I'll explain this one more time, it will be very long, so let me move forward. Let's revise this once again up to the synthesis of L-phenylalanine from succinic acid. Okay, succinic acid in presence of enzyme succinate kinase, whenever kinase enzyme is there, there is incorporation of phosphate group. So in succinic acid there is incorporation of phosphate at position number 3. Its name is succinic acid 3-phosphate, and the next enzyme which comes in action is EPSP synthase. It will produce EPSP. Its name is enol pyruvyl succinic acid 3-phosphate. And next enzyme which comes in action is a coricimate synthase. It will give rise to coricic acid, and from this coricic acid in presence of enzyme coricimate mutase, perphenic acid is formed. And from perphenic acid in presence of enzyme perphenate dehydratase, phenyl pyruvic acid is formed. And from this phenyl pyruvic acid in presence of enzyme pyridoxal phosphate and phenyl pyruvate aminotransferase, L-phenylalanine is formed. And L-phenylalanine can form cinnamic acid if there is elimination of ammonia. And this was all from succinic acid to L-phenylalanine. Now we have to also discuss the synthesis of L-tyrosine and tryptophan. We have to revise this once again. Let's revise it. From coricic acid, we have already discussed how this forms. From coricic acid, in presence of enzyme coricimate mutase, perphenic acid forms. And perphenic acid in presence of enzyme perphenate aminotransferase, amino group gets transferred to keto position of this perphenic acid group. L-arogenic acid is formed, and from this L-arogenic acid, here is arogenate dehydrogenase, and from this presence of this enzyme, carbon dioxide gets removed from there, CO2, and L-tyrosine is formed. and another reaction here from this coricemic acid in presence of enzyme 2-amino-2-deoxyisocoricemate synthase. This is formed 2-amino-2-deoxyisocoricemic acid, and from this 2-amino-2-deoxyisocoricemic acid in presence of enzyme 2-amino-2-deoxyisocoricemate lyase, anthranilic acid is formed. And anthranilic acid, after four major reactions catalyzed by four enzymes, it will only give rise to L-tryptophan. So this was all. If you have any questions, you can ask me in the comment section. It will be very long if I revise this once again, so I have to move forward. Let's see the significance of succinic acid pathway. I have also discussed previously in the reaction process also, and let's see here also. Ellagic acid is a product obtained from gallic acid. We have discussed about gallic acid in our that video. You can go back to the video and see again. Salicylic acid, okay. PABA, these are prepared from coricemic acid. PABA forms a part of the structure folic acid. And salicylic acid is an analgesic and antipyretic. Salicylic acid provides template for aspirin. This is also the significance of succinic acid pathway. And folic acid gets further converted to tetrahydrofolate. Alright, and this pathway can be incorporated to produce antibacterial, antimalarial, and anti-cancer drugs. And chloramphenicol is a very useful antibiotic, which is produced from 4-amino-4-deoxycoricemic acid. And other significance, cinnamaldehyde comes from cinnamic acid. It gives rise to eosinol, isoeosinol, anethol, myristicin, and others. The cinnamaldehyde, it comes from cinnamic acid, and cinnamic acid comes from where? It comes from L-phenylalanine. And from that cinnamaldehyde, these various structures can be formed. And cinnamic acid also gives rise to coumarins and umbelliferone. And coumarin is a flavoring agent, and umbelliferone is used in sunscreens and as an antioxidant. And the last significance I have shown here is products formed from cinnamoyl coenzyme A, a product of cinnamic acid, plus one or two C2 units from malonyl coenzyme A. And if malonyl coenzyme A as two carbon are added in this cinnamoyl coenzyme A, it provides the platform for synthesis of piperin, curcumin, and other flavonoids. So there are many significance of this succinic pathway. It is a bit complex. If you have any problem in any part of the video, you can comment in the comment section. Okay, see you next video. Thank you.